creature, the one and only, my superhero from Staffordshire. He only ever had it off a few times. And when he did, women screamed, in horror that is. One of wrestling's all-time greats, Kendo Nagasaki. Later on, tag teams from both sides of the pond faced off against each other as Ireland faced Canada.
Welcome, Grapple fans. Oh, him. Parody, as in sick ass. Everybody else in wrestling's got a gimmick. I've got to have one. Kendo Nagasaki, a redolent name. A man of mystery, footed wrestler of the millennium. But some people said behind that mask was simply Peter Thornley from Stoke-on-Trent. Kendo harboured a host of grudges, particularly against Giant Haystacks, who unmasked him foully in 1991. Will he sit still while I'm on? He packed in wrestling in 2000, hoping to find a student of the art to pass on his wisdom to. Cast your mind back, if you will, to 1986. The Communards had the top pop song of the year. Argentina won the World Cup. And Jossie's Giants, a rolling and tailor football folk, was the top kids' television programme. Meanwhile, in our world, Nagasaki, looking determined, went to London to take on Iron Fist Clive Myers in a disco challenge at the Hippodrome nightclub. Disco challenge? You don't believe me? Watch this. It's just an
illusion. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for our special 1987 series, this equally very special match to open. The only conditions of this match, which are made under the All-American rules, are that the wrestlers, one of them or the other, must get out of the ring, collect this stepladder that you can see beside the ring here, bring it into the ring, climb up the ladder, and get that golden disc which is hanging above us. That's the way the match is won. There are no other conditions. Now, ladies and gentlemen, out of the blue corner, it's my pleasure to ask you to welcome Iron Fist Clive Myers. And from the red corner, presented, of course, by George Gillette, will you welcome Kendo Nagasaki?
Ladies and gentlemen, you think, because Kendo has been away for a while, that you stand any chance at all. You stand none, because there's only ever one victor in any bout that Kendo has associated, and that is Kendo Nagasaki.
So here we go for the first part of our 20-minute duration. No rounds, no falls or submissions here. What John Harris explained to you, and I'll do it again in a little time.
Commence wrestling.
Commence wrestling for the first part of this very exciting new experience. I've never seen it before any more than you have. As you heard John Harris say, one of them has got to fetch that golden ladder from outside the ring, bring it ring center, and collect the golden disc which is hanging high above the ring. This is the disco part of the performance coming up. There you saw the golden disc. Right now, the disco part of the performance. Here they go. must realize by now that the wrestling rules are a little bit different here this afternoon, this special gala show. All American rules, all in American rules here. That's why practically anything goes. Frank Casey will have no problems here this afternoon as the referee. Fighting outside the ring, which of course in America that's legal. All in rules permit fighting outside the ring as much as it. Remember when watching this, no falls or submissions as we're used to, just to get that ladder in position to climb up it and get hold of that golden disc hanging above the ring. That's the whole point. He's got it, yes. Kendo Nagasaki, the legendary man from the old days of wrestling. Would love to see him back in the ring, but he's got this one, this special golden disc now, right in his hand there. There's George Gillette, his manager. He said that he'd win, and he did.
Ladies and gentlemen, you haven't seen him for a while, but you're going to be seeing an awful lot more of this man. Because here is the world's most invincible wrestler, victorious as ever, Kendo Nagasaki.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match with the disc in his hand, Kendo Nagasaki.
Sing What Ails Wrestling Show.
Oh, welcome back, Grapple fans. Now, they say that Canada has got some really big Rocky Mountains. Well, Ireland's got some too, in the shape of Rocky Moran and Dave Fit Finlay. That pair take on Canada's Hart brothers.
Hello again, Grapple fans, and glad you joined us here at the Civic Hall, Guildford, for this all-session tag team time. It's two semi-finals and one final here this afternoon. Four countries fighting in tag for a very nice silver trophy, which we'll see no doubt later on. Ireland, Canada, England, and the West Indies. And we start from the draw, which was Dave Fit Finlay and Rocky Moran for Ireland versus Ross and Owen Hart from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. 20 minutes duration each tag bout. Two falls, two submissions, two knockouts, or two disqualifications to decide the winners. And that's young Owen Hart, a mere 18 years old, coming against the world mid-heavyweight title holder, Dave Fit Finlay, for Ireland. Peter Zakash, the referee there. Young Owen stopped him there, all right. Goes back into a quick bridge, but he stopped him for a moment. Not for too long. And a tag, in comes Rocky Moran for Ireland from Lisburn near Belfast. His partner, of course, Finlay from Belfast. Owen Hart, 18 years old, Calgary, Alberta, 12 stone 7. His brother Ross, waiting outside the tag rope at 13'3". So Moran versus Owen Ross. And a tag. In comes Finlay versus Owen, but no, it tags Ross. Ross Hart versus Finlay. And both the Canadian wrestlers have got their flash stars around their trunks to help us identify. Also, the Canadian wrestlers always wear the knee protectors. Their first visit to this country. And I hope hope Peter Sarkis is going to be tougher than that in this special tag tournament. Nice box, let's stop him. Rocky Moran tags from the other side, but perfectly legally, and comes in against Ross Hart. In this first box, in this first semi-final, the so-called Gopher crowd really starting to warm up to us. I think this is one of the first times, if not the first time, that we've ever had a whole afternoon World of Sport wrestling session with nothing but tag wrestling. Good posting by Moran. In comes Owen, a young boy, 18 years old, against Rocky Moran for the first time. Nice throw, lovely arm there by Owen. These Ross boys are only here for a few weeks. In fact, they go back very shortly to Canada. We have seen a couple of their brothers over here before. We've seen Bruce and Bret Hart over here, Cowboy Smith Hart. But this is only the second time we've had a chance to see the two young ones, Ross and Owen. Owen is doing all right against Rocky Moran of Northern Ireland. Come on. Still no score, but one public warning against Finlay. Victory roll down and over the top for and holding the legs, that could be trouble for him. It is the first one, Moran over Owen Hart. In just 7 minutes, 45 seconds of the first session. Finlay and Moran from Belfast, or thereabouts, quite easily getting the first ball over the 18-year-old Owen Hart. Now the question is, can the Hart brothers come back in this first semi-final?
Seconds away, the second session.
Owen must continue against Moran, of course. Owen taking quite a time to come in. He steps back a lot and deliberates a little too much. I wish he could get to his corner and get a chance for Ross to come in. Moran follows up with a body check on the ropes, but and he dices it down by Hart. Oh yes, that's a special, special takes his man back and gives him unawares and a shoulder press. Beautifully done, and everybody loves that idea. Great idea. The crowd love it. In just 9 minutes, 10 seconds, the second session, Owen Hart gets the equalizer over Moran. Hear some great crowd reaction from them. They love the idea of the Canadian boys coming back against the Northern Ireland boys. Obviously, know the experience here on the right hand corner. They're back in the game now. 1-4 each.
To end the third and final session.
Here we go for the final session. We're just about halfway through, I think, about 10 minutes, a little less to go. And it's got to be Moran against Owen Hart again. They've got to restart.
10 minutes.
And 10 minutes. There's the call for 10 minutes. Halfway through the bar. And can Owen do the same trick? And a public warning for Moran for that.
And Rocky Moran gets his first public warning.
So he quickly gets out of the ring, tags Finlay, and in comes Ross Hart for the first time against Finlay in this session.
side of the forearm, okay.
All right, got it. Two.
Drop kick from the ground position. Oh, missed the drop kick though. Pity he missed that follow up. Ross Hart in trouble with the Boston crowd now. If he gets that submission, Fenley has got him, and they've beaten Canada. Single leg Boston now. Hart still in trouble, but he's grabbing for a tag and he gets the tag. In comes Owen fast against Finley. Still Owen Hart. Takes an awful long time deliberating before he comes forward. Finley won't give him that chance, and that could be a punch. Posting after posting. This boy taking. This time he's held it and he tried the same move again. Can he get Finley? But no, Finley waiting for him, unfortunately. And it didn't work this time. It caught Moran by surprise, Finley's partner. But Finley knew what to expect this time. And this is a Finley special, and over the top for a cross press. And trouble for Owen Hart here. Yes, no problem. So it's 12 minutes.
Golden
Island!